In this video, I'll show you three easy ways to analyze your energy usage with degree days. Degree days are used to take weather out of the equation when analyzing energy consumption. ISO 50001 calls this normalization. This is a basic concept that should be applied by anyone who wants to analyze and optimize their energy usage. In the next minutes, you will learn about the efficiency ratio approach, the long-term average, and the base year normalization. Let's start with the efficiency ratio approach. The efficiency ratio is a simple way to understand weather-corrected energy performance. In this simplified example, we have the energy usage for heating on an annual basis for 3 years. The absolute numbers are showing that compared to 2019, we saved some kilowatt hours in 2020 and then had a large increase in 2021. Let's check how our performance was compared to the weather conditions in these years. To calculate heating degree days, you need to know the base temperature for heating of your building. Combined with your location, you can easily get the accurate degree days with our degree day calculator for free. To get the efficiency ratio for each period, you just divide your usage by the sum of degree days in that specific period. If you now compare the efficiency ratios, you will notice that 2020 was efficiency-wise the worst year and should be analyzed more in detail. Although this method is easy and fast to implement, these ratios are not as easy to grab as kilowatt hours. So let's correct the actual energy usage in kilowatt hours. A common approach is normalization by using long-term averages. We go back to our example, but now we add another variable, the 10-year average of heating degree days. Of course, location, base temperature, and length of the period should be the same. Our free degree day calculator will calculate long-term average with just one click. And to normalize the energy consumption, you check how many degree days in your period there have been compared to the long-term average. And this factor will be multiplied by the actual usage, and the result is normalized usage in kilowatt hours. As we already noticed, 2020 had weather corrected the worst energy performance. The last approach is very similar and called base year normalization. Instead of using long-term average values for correction, you can set a base year and compare the number of degree days and the energy usage to that year. Now you know three concepts to use degree days in your energy usage analysis. These concepts can be used for both heating and cooling degree days. You may ask yourself, which method should I choose? There is no one correct method, and which one you choose may also depend on the data you have and the software you use. These numbers here show that the choice of the normalization method is not that important, because percentage-wise, they come to the same conclusion. But comparing the normalized results with the actual usage show how vital weather correction is for not taking false conclusions based on your meter readings. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos on energy management. And also check out our free tools like the degree day calculator and the energy normalizer on energy-data.io.